Hey everybody, today we're going to learn how to actually take a Camtasia video and to quickly and easily add different chapter points and a menu that would actually allow the user to jump to these different parts of your video. It's really quick and easy, and I'm going to show you that today. All right, welcome back. And if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts on topics on augmented reality, storyline, XAPI, Camtasia. You can also go into my template section and download different templates right now on storyline and XAPI, and Camtasia templates will be coming soon. And then you can also check out my full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, everything from A to Z, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. Now I am working on a Camtasia everything from A to Z course as well, so you can check that out later. However, today I'm going to show you a quick tip on what you can do inside of Camtasia to easily add chapters and then have, when you export out your video, using their smart player, allow the learner to actually jump to different points in those chapters. And if you aren't already aware, you can actually even publish this to Scorm and wrap this up and upload it to your learning management system. So we're going to walk through all of that today. So I have a project already pulled up here, and you can see in this project, it's just a simple tutorial walking through a certain application here. Now, if you wanted to add chapter points where the learner can jump back to certain parts, or they can jump to and refer back to parts as needed, you can use Camtasia's smart player. Now, when you export out a Camtasia project, you could export out the MP4 file and just upload it to YouTube or something like that. So you don't have to use their player, but they do have the ability to add on some functionality if you do use their player. So I'm going to go ahead and inside of Camtasia, I'm going to start adding some chapters. Now I'm going to add a chapter at the very beginning here. So I'm going to go ahead and just select this drop-down box here. And you can see that I can add a quiz. And if I'm going to put this on a learning management system, I can insert a quiz. Now I'm going to cover a quiz and how to do the quiz in a future video. But for now, we're going to go ahead and just add a marker. If I come in and add a marker here, then I have this little area where I can add a plus diamond here at any point in the video. I'm going to add one at the very beginning. Now over on the right hand side, this is where it will show up. It'll say marker, but that's how I can rename the marker. Now this is important because this is what becomes part of your menu. So you want to describe it with that section in the video. So this is the introduction. This is the very beginning. So I'm going to go ahead and call it introduction here. And I can always come back in here and select that marker and go rechange it as needed. So I'm going to come in here and add another chapter. So this will be something about logging in. Not specifically timed up to this video right now, but that's not the point. We're just covering how to do this. So now I'm going to come in here to a different section, and then I'm going to say view plan. So I'm going to click on this, and this is where, because the tool itself is like a plan tool, and so I'm going to say view plan. Let's add a couple more here. So this one is going to be add note here. And this is up to you how you want to describe it. And then I'm going to add here view completed. There we go. So we've added our markers. We can always come back in and select the marker and edit it. So if I select that marker here, I can come over to the right hand side and I can see that. If you don't see this by any means, then you can come over here to your properties and select your properties. This properties window changes based on what you have selected, so keep that in mind. All right, so we have our chapters in place. So now we need to export out our video and we need to build this player, and then we can see the output here. So I'm gonna go ahead and go into file, and then I'm going to export here and then do not a local file, because a local file just does an MP4. Now this may look a little bit different, but on a Windows, but you can get the idea here and find the same similar menu. Then we come into export and we can do local file. Now local file is actually when you can do an MP4 file and not export out the player as well. So keep that in mind, but we're not uploading it to YouTube directly. We're not uploading it to Vimeo. You can if you wanted to, but it will not add this smart player. So I'm gonna go to local file here. And this will add me or allow me to decide where I want to save this, which I'm going to save it on my desktop. And then this is where I say the file format. Now, I can do this as an animated GIF. I'm not sure if you knew that, but you can actually export out animated GIFs, and you can take those GIFs and put them on websites, and you can have animations with kind of like a job aid and stuff, which is pretty cool. But I'm going to go to Export MP4. This is where I can go into options and I can adjust like the frame rates if I wanted to. I can adjust the data rates and other things if you wanted to get very detailed. But I'm going to export this as a web page. This is the smart player that gets added here. So as soon as I select that, I have a couple different options. So these options are the export size, the 1920 by 1080, if you want to preserve that aspect ratio. But if you're targeting something like TikTok or something like that, you could actually adjust the canvas size and you can export it out that way. So keep that in mind. But I'm going to skip this part for now. We're going to come back to this that includes SCORM. But this is really what I'm looking for. Create table of contents from markers. So it's going to take all the markers that we just inserted and it's going to create this table of contents. So I'm going to go ahead and click on export here. And depending on the size of the video, it may take a little while to export. All right, so through the magic of editing, I sped that up here, but now I'm going to go ahead and click on close. And we're going to go to our desktop and we're going to open up our desktop here and we're going to see exactly what gets created. So you can see that it's an index.html file. It's a CSS file as well, which handles the style of it. And then there's a media folder. Now the media folder is where I can find additional content. And you can see like template quiz preview. You can see scripts and other things. You probably don't want to mess with all of that. This is where your MP4 file is. So you could still take it and you could upload it to Vimeo or YouTube or something. But I'm going to come in and I'm just going to double click on this index.html. Index.html, if you're not familiar, is usually the homepage of a website. And so if you're going to google.com, it ignores the index.html. You don't have to type in index.html. It just finds whatever is labeled as index.html, and that's what gets served up as the homepage. So in this case, if I upload this to my website and I put it in a folder, learningdojo.ninja, and I put it in a folder called video, I don't have to type in index.html. I just type in learningdojo.ninja/video, and it will go right to this homepage. That's how the web kind of works. Your main file usually is your index.html file. So I'm going to double click on this, and you can see this is the video player. Has me just click on play here.
Hey, everybody, this is Jeff.
And it will start to play. Now, I am not running this in a local.
Hey, everybody, this is.
Like sometimes when I first hit play, it's like completely black. So I just hit refresh there. When this is on a website, it won't do that. But that's just kind of when I'm running locally. Now, this is the smart player down at the bottom. So you can see volume. It tries to take up the full screen. But this is your chapters. So if you click on this, every word that I actually typed in, the markers pops open as a little thumbnail. And I can jump to that section of the video. So I'm going to click on that. And you'll notice that the video has actually jumped to it. But the nice thing is I can also search for it. So I can start typing in notes, and then it will prompt me with a note, and then I can jump to that portion of the video as well. So I did not need to do any type of coding to do this. I can just export it out. So it's a really nice way to be able to jump to different parts and reference different parts and even search for different parts of the video if a learner needs to come back to this. So let's go back into Camtasia and let's talk about exporting it as SCORM. So we know how to add the chapters, and the way that I did it allows me to just put it on my website somewhere, or you could embed it in a SharePoint or something like that. But I'm going to go into file and then I'm going to go to export and local file. Now I'm going to do this again and I'm going to export it as a web page, but I'm going to include SCORM and also table of contents. Now if I go into SCORM and click on options here, this allows me to add some important SCORM information. So this is what's going to be read inside of your learning management system. So you need to give it an ID, and most learning management systems will either auto-generate an ID or allow you to insert an ID. And so this is basically up there, but you can just put in whatever ID that you want. So you could do like whatever your organization is, dash whatever your department is as well, dash 001, or like whatever theme of the course. Again, you can get it, just have some type of scheme across your, whenever you publish out courses here. Now you could give it a title, which this title is going to be working with the plan tool. And then I can give it a description. Now, I don't necessarily have to do this. When I upload the SCORM package, I can actually define this inside of the learning management system. But it'll save me some time if I do this here and then upload it, because it will read this information when I upload it to a learning management system. And then I can say, what version do I want to do it? SCORM 1.2, SCORM 2004 to the 4th edition, 3rd edition, and 2nd edition. What I usually tell people is it depends on your learning management system. If your learning management system handles SCORM 1.2 better, publish to SCORM 1.2. SCORM 2004 gives you some additional features, but with Camtasia videos, it doesn't really play a factor in unless you're using the quiz questions and so forth. Honestly, just, you know, ask your learning management system, what do you recommend, and publish it out to there. I do hope that Camtasia releases a future version that will allow me to export to XAPI packages or CMI5. So that would be nice to be able to get some additional information with the video. And if you want that, I actually have a wrapper that you can download on my templates website for that. All right, so if you come into SCORM 2004, this is the language, and then this is the duration, and then lesson information. You can basically duplicate the title that you have up here. That's if you want to alter it a little bit. And then video percentage required. How much do they have to get through in the video in order for this to be counted as complete? I accidentally exited out of that, but I typically say 80%, because especially if you have a video that has like a little icon that shows up at the end of it, like I do with this video, sometimes people will close it before they actually watch the entire thing. So if you do 80%, you'll know that they've gotten through the majority of the content, and then it will count it as complete there. All right, SCORM package options. Produce SCORM zip, which is exactly what we want, because when you upload a content or a piece of learning content to a learning management system, it has to be zipped in a certain way. So produce zipped file, produce unzipped file if you need to do anything else there, and then produce both zip file and unzip files if you wanted to do both for some reason. We're going to just produce a zip file. Click OK, and then I'm going to go ahead and hit export. I already have a folder because I published this out already. I have a folder named project. I'm just going to go ahead and overwrite that and then produce that. Now, depending on the size of your video, this will take a little while, but it's going to produce everything I need in order to then upload this to the learning management system. Okay, there we go. If you don't want this little prompt to pop up every single time after the video is done, you can go ahead and click on Don't Show Again and then hit Close. And then I'm going to go ahead and hide that. And for some reason, I placed it inside of a folder. I'm not sure why, but there's my zipped file. This is what I can upload to. I can get rid of that folder. But I can upload this to the learning management system. You take that and you upload it. Now, if I double click on it here, I just want to explore what's inside here, because we have similar files that we did before. We have the index.html, but we have additional files like the projectplayer.html, projectembed.html as well. But we have some IMS manifest files. Those are SCORM files. Those need to be there, so don't delete those or anything. You're packaging this all up and you're uploading it to the LMS, so it's very important here. Now, if you wanted to, one other thing that I failed to mention, so that's how you make it SCORM compliant, but one other thing that I failed to mention is I'm going to export this out again, and I'm going to still add on the web page, but I'm going to add on this table of contents. And I'm going to click on export, and we're going to explore how you can actually even customize the CSS next. All right, so now this part is totally optional, but if you come in here and you take your project and you go into this embed.css, if you have a tool like Visual Studio Code or Sublime Code or something like that, you can actually open it up here and you can see the background color. You could go in and see the box sizing for the body. The smart player, it will automatically center, and that's the margin left and margin right. And it will actually take up the max width. It's going to be 1920 pixels. And so it's not going to go beyond that. That smart player is not going to go beyond that. It could if you wanted it to, but it will just, I mean, that's how it is by default. So you have the ability to come in here and add on your own CSS or adjust the CSS as well. So I like how flexible this is, this smart player here. Now, there are additional things that you could do. You don't have to use their player. In fact, if you go back to my website, there are some things like adding the local video right here. This will trigger X API statements, and at the very beginning and at the very end if you wanted to have X API. And then also different like info pop-ups and different quiz questions if you go to interactive video, and you can see that as well, which I have a whole video on how to use that template. So a lot of different options here, but I do like the defaults, the ability to create these chapters, the ability to publish out a Scorm package right within Camtasia. So there's a lot that you can do here out of the box with Camtasia. And hopefully this was useful for you. Don't forget to check out my website with these templates, also my previous blog posts, and then my full courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm HTML5 video with a full course on Camtasia coming soon. If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Leave a comment. What other videos of Camtasia or other tools do you want to see? And I will start working on those as well. So leave a comment down below on that and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. But that's it. That's all that I have for today. So I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, everyone.